Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.3, Problem 2. This is Section 9.3, Problem number 2. It says, for each of the following studies, determine if the study is sufficiently large to compute a confidence interval for the proportion of the population of homes that have internet access. So your study has to be large enough, and what we have to determine when we say is it's sufficiently large, we need to verify that n times p, and we're going to use p hat as an estimate for p, is at least 5. It's going to be 5 or more, and we also have to verify that n times 1 minus p is also at least 5, that it's 5 more. So for each case, that's what we have to figure out. So for part A, 50 homes are studied, 48 of those 50 homes had internet access. So is that study large enough? Can we make a population proportion, a confidence interval for the population proportion? So first, let's estimate P. What is P, or P hat we would call it? So 48 is the number of successful results over the total number of trials is 50. So with a calculator, you can divide that out. 48 divided by 50 will be 0.96. So let's check n times p. So n, the number of homes surveyed, would be 50 times p, and we're estimating p with our 0.96. That multiplies out to 48. So that's bigger than 5. But let's also do n times 1 minus p. So n is still 50. 1 minus p will be 1 minus 0.96. So let's simplify that. I still have 50. 1 minus 0.96 would be 0.04. And now if I multiply 50 times 0.04, that's 2. That's not at least 5. So n times p is okay, but n times 1 minus p is not, and they both have to be at least 5. So for part A, is the study sufficiently large to have a confidence interval for population proportion? No, it's not. Now B is really similar. 50 homes are studied, 38 of those 50 homes did have internet access. Will this be sufficiently large? Still 50 homes, so it's not just how many homes are studied. So let's check the same thing. Does n times p come out to be at least 5? And does n times 1 minus p come out to be at least 5? So let's do the same type of computation. So before it was 48 divided by 50. For part b, it's 38. So our estimate for p is 0.76 when you divide 38 divided by 50. You can do that on your calculator. So n times p, which we did before, n times p, instead of times 0.96 the way we did for part A, is 50 times 0.76 for b, which does come out to 38. That's at least 5, so that's okay. And it was okay before, so let's see if the n times 1 minus p is okay this time. So n times 1 minus p, before it was 50 times 1 minus, it was 0.96 for part A, but for part B it's going to be times 0.76. So that 1 minus 0.76 is 0.24, so the n is 50 times 0.24 for the 1 minus p. That comes out to 12. That's at least 5. So n times p is big enough, it's 38, which is at least 5. N times 1 minus p comes out to 12, which is bigger than 5. So for part b, which really has the same number of homes studied, it's the ratio of successes to the sample size, really. Yes, it is big enough. And then c, 600. So just because the number has gotten bigger, that's not going to be a guarantee that it's a big enough study. It's that ratio, again, 561 is getting close to the whole 600. Is that sufficiently large to make a confidence interval for the population proportion? So let's determine the same type of things. Is n times p at least 5? And n times 1 minus p, is that also at least 5? So, for part C, the N is the 600. The P, I have to figure out the P. So, P is 561 divided by 600. So that's something you'll probably want to do with your calculator. 561 divided by 600 equals, and it's going to come out to 0.935. So 600 for N and times P is 0.935. And if you multiply that out, that does come out to 561. That's certainly bigger than 5. So the N times P comes out to be at least 5. That's good. Let's next try N times 1 minus P. So the N, again, the size of my sample is 600, times 1 minus P. The value for P came out to 0.935 from dividing the 561 over 600. So 1 minus 0.935, that's 1 minus P. So let me keep the 600 for the left parenthesis. 1 minus 0.935 is 0.065. And then if you multiply 600 times 0.065, that result is 39. That's bigger than 5. So N times P is bigger than 5 at 561. N times 1 minus P is bigger than 5 at 39. So the answer for part C, is my study sufficiently large to make the confidence interval I'm looking for? Yes, it is sufficiently large.